Hi, this is Ali Hajihashemi from SK Ghosh Associates, and I would like to welcome you to a brief overview of the application guide for the 2012 IBC Concrete Provisions. Authored by Dr. Ghosh and myself, this book consists of three parts as well as two appendices. Part 1 starts with an introduction that briefly traces the evolution of the concrete chapter in the IBC from its first edition to the 2012 edition. This part also provides section-by-section description of Chapter 19 of the Code and corresponding sections in its reference standard ACI 318.11, which are simply referenced by the code without any modifications. Numerous tables and figures are used throughout this publication to better summarize and illustrate the applications. In detail discussion on Section 1905 of the Code is probably one of the most beneficial segments of the book, which addresses a problem that code users, including building officials, plan reviewers, architects, and engineers, absolutely need to be aware of. The concrete chapter of the 2012 IBC, referencing ACI 318.11, was finalized long before the reference standard was changed from ACI 318.08 to ACI 318.11. This book comprehensively explains the adjustments required to make Section 1905 of the 2012 IBC consistent with the reference standard ACI 318.11. In addition, appendix to part 1 of the book provides an adaptive ordinance containing modifications which are needed to restore the consistency between the code and the reference standard. Besides the changes in the text of Chapter 19, changes have been taken place between ACI 318.08 and ACI 318.11, which have significant effects on the design and construction of concrete structures. These changes are the subject of Part 2 of the book. This is a very valuable feature of the book, which not only covers the changes that you find in the code, but also goes over the changes in the reference standard. Part 3 of the book includes 12 design examples, which cover a wide variety of topics, including unified design examples, design of connections in a special moment precast frame building, design of anchor bolts based on both allowable stress design in IBC and Appendix D of ACI 318, illustration of the strong column weak beam requirements, design of a two-way flat plate, design of special shear walls, application of the shear friction method, and application of the strut and tie models. Finally, Appendix to Part 3 of the book captures a topic that has created confusion and difficulties for code users. This appendix explains different cases of concrete breakout failure of anchors in shear based on Appendix D of ACI 318. This book is a must-have for all code users dealing with concrete structures, and will hopefully be a place to go in order to find answers to your questions. Thank you for your interest.